Hello everyone, in this lecture we are just going to see how we can interface LCD displays to our Arduino using Arduino IDE. Let's get started. The LCD that we are going to use is 16x2 alphanumeric LCD, which is having Hitachi HD44780 driver in it. So this LCD is having 16 columns and 2 rows in it, so that you can display maximum of 32 characters at a time in this display. I have explained the working principle of this display, how the data is being transferred from a microcontroller to this display in a separate LCD working lecture. The link for that lecture is provided in the description of this video. If you have missed that lecture, you can go back to that lecture using the link provided. And these are the 16 pinouts of the LCD display. And the first pin is nothing but the VSS, which is the ground pin. And second pin is nothing but the VDD. So you can provide a maximum of 5 volt to the VDD of this LCD. And third pin is nothing but the VEE, which is the contrast varying pin. And according to the voltage provided to this pin, the contrast of the font that is being displayed in this display will be varying. So we will be connecting a potentiometer or variable resistor to this VEE pin so that we can vary the contrast of the font that is available in the LCD. So 15th pin is nothing but the anode of the LED, which is provided as a backlight for this LCD. And 16th pin is the cathode of the same. So you can vary the brightness of the backlight LED for this LCD by providing or by varying the voltage provided to this anode pin of the backlight LED. So fourth pin is nothing but the RS pin, which is the register selector, which is used for varying the differentiation between the command and data passed to this LCD. And fifth pin is RW, which is used for differentiating either we are going to write to the LCD or we are going to read from the LCD. We will be only writing to the LCD, so we will be directly grounding this pin for that purpose. So 0 means writing to the LCD and 1 means reading from the LCD. So this enable pin, which is the 6th pin, is the clock for the LCD. Whatever process you are doing to this LCD, either you are passing a data or command, you just want to enable this pin so that the data will be properly passed. And rest 8 pins starting from D0 to D7 are the data lines of the LCD using which you can pass the data. So if you are passing the data in an 8-bit format to this LCD, you will be using all these 8 lines. But we are just going to use the 4-bit format for this LCD. So we will not be using the D0 to D3, we will be using only the data lines from D4 to D7, that is the MSB data lines of the LCD. So these are the pins we are going to use, the power rail, and then we will be using RS, and we will be grounding the RW, and we will be using the enable pin, and then for the data lines, we will be using D4, D5, D6 and D7. And regarding the pinouts of the Arduino Uno, we know this is the Arduino Uno development board, and this is the analog pins A0 to A5, and this is the digital pin starting from digital pin 0 to digital pin 13. You can also use the analog pin as digital, but for now we will be using only the digital IOs of the Arduino Uno. So I will be connecting the RS to digital pin 13, RW to ground, and enable pin to digital pin 12, and D4 will be connected to digital pin 8, D5 to digital pin 9, D6 to digital pin 10, and D7 to digital pin 11. So these are the connections that I am going to make. And this is the circuit that I am going to build using a breadboard and Arduino Uno development board. You can see, as per the previous connections, I have connected the Arduino Uno digital pins to the LCD display. And regarding the power supply section, you can see VSS is connected to the ground, VDD is connected to 5 volt, and VEE is connected to a potentiometer or variable resistor of 10 kilo ohms, and one end of the variable resistor is connected to 5 volt and opposite end is connected to the ground. And regarding the anode and cathode pin connections, I will be connecting a 1 kilo ohm resistor from the VDD pin to this anode, and this cathode pin I will be directly connecting it to ground. So that's all about the schematic and circuit connections that I'm going to make. I will be powering up this Arduino using the USB port of the PC using the USB cable. So coming to our program, we are just going to use the liquid crystal library that is available in the Arduino IDE. So I'm opening my Arduino IDE, and initially I just want to add the library to my user program. So that can be done by writing as include liquidcrystal.h. So now I have successfully added the liquid crystal library to my program. We are just going to see what are all these liquid crystal functions that is available in the library, and we are just going to demonstrate all these functions in the hardware. So for initializing the LCD, we just want to assign the LCD pins, right? So that can be done by declaring a liquid crystal variable. So I can type liquid crystal of LCD. So this name, that is LCD, is a user defined name. You can give any name for the LCD. So I'm typing SM of. So this variable receives several formats according to your requirement or according to the configuration that you are doing to the LCD. You can configure the LCD in an 8-bit format or in a 4-bit format. That is, for example, this is the first method. That is, if you are passing a 7 parameters to this variable, that means first parameter will be taken as the RS pin, and second parameter will be taken as RW, and third will be enable pin, and rest 4 will be D4, D5, D6 and D7. So we have connected the LCD in 4-bit format according to our schematic. So we are just going to use the 6 parameter format like this. So in this method, we are just going to connect the RW pin to ground. So the first parameter will be taken as RS and second will be enable, and rest 4 will be D4, D5, D6 and D7. And rest 2 formats, that is these 2 formats, is based on the 8-bit configuration for LCD. That is, we just want to pass 11 argument to this variable, so that the first will be RS, second will be RW and third will be enable, and rest 8 will be the data lines from D0 to D7. So you just want to connect the D0 to D7 to the respective pins of the Arduino. And the fourth format is again a simple one, that is, we are just going to pass 10 parameters to this function, so that the first will be RS and RW, we will be connecting it to ground directly, and the second will be enable, and rest 8 will be data lines from D0 to D7. So for increasing the readability of the program, we will be configuring or we will be renaming the pin numbers of our Arduino in our user program. So that can be done by writing const int of RS equal to, so according to our schematic, we have connected the RS to 13, so I'm writing 13, and enable pin to 12. You can see this, and D4, D5, D6, D7 is connected to 11, 10, 9 and 8. So I can write D4 equal to 11, D5 equal to 10, D6 equal to 9, D7 equal to 8. So now wherever I want to write the pin number 13 or simply 13, I can use the name RS in my program. So wherever I want to write a digital pin 12, I can use the name enable. So likewise, I can use these usernames all over my program for increasing the readability of the program. So this is a very good practice. Now, as I said, we are just going to initialize the LCD in 4-bit format with RW pin ground. So I'm just going to use this format. So I'm writing RS, enable, D4, D5, D6, D7. So now I'm configuring my LCD in 4-bit format with RW grounded. So that's all, the pin configuration for the LCD is done. Now we just want to set the initialization parameter for the LCD. For that, we just want to use the begin function. So this function receives two parameters totally. First parameter is the number of columns that we are going to use in the LCD, and second parameter is the number of rows we are initializing in the LCD. So I can write sm dot. So for calling any function that is available in the LiquidCrystal library, we are just going to use this variable sm. That is the user defined variable. You can also give any name for your LCD variable according to your wish. So now sm.begin of, as I said, we are just going to use these 16 columns in the LCD and 2 rows. So this is the number of columns that we are going to use in the LCD, and this is the number of rows we are going to use. So now the LCD will be initialized with 16 columns and 2 rows. And the next function is setCursor. So before printing anything to the LCD, we just want to set where we want to print in the LCD, right? That is, we are having totally 16 columns and 2 rows in the LCD. So we just want to define where we want to print the content. So that can be set by setting this cursor. So sm dot set cursor of, this also receives two parameters. First one is the column number and second one is the row number. So this column number can be from 0 to 15. As we know, there are 16 columns. First column is the 0th column and final column is the 15th column. So this row number is based on number of rows. So we know that we are having totally 2 rows in our LCD. So we can give either 0 or 1. That is, 0 means first row and 1 means second row. So that's all about the column and row numbers. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to the 0th column and 0th row, and I will be printing the content hello world. So for printing that content, I'm just going to use this print function, sm.print. So to this function, you can pass a character like this, or you can directly pass a string of data like this. So now the LCD will be configured with these pins in 4-bit format, and it will be initialized with 16 columns and 2 rows, and then I'm setting the cursor at 0th column and 0th row, and I'm printing the content hello world, which is a string. So that's all about the program. Now I'm uploading the sketch to my Arduino Uno. Now you can see the hello world string is printed on to the first row of the LCD. Using this variable resistor, you can fine tune your font contrast that is available in your LCD. You just want to vary this variable resistor until you get a clear font in your LCD. And the next function is clear. So this function is used for clearing the display content that is available in the LCD. That is, if you are printing something on the LCD, if you call this function once, everything that is available in the LCD will be cleared. Let's demonstrate that. So after printing the hello world content, I'm just going to give a delay of 2 seconds, and then I'm calling the clear function. So after the hello world has been printed, I'm waiting for 2 seconds, and after 2 seconds, I'm just calling this clear function so that everything that is available in the LCD will be cleared. I'm uploading the sketch, and you can see hello world is printed now, and after 2 seconds it is cleared. And the next function is home. So this function call, actually what it does is that it will set the cursor position to the 0th column and 0th row of the LCD. So wherever may be the cursor point of the LCD currently, if you make a function call sm.home, it will set the cursor position to the 0th row and 0th column. We will not be demonstrating that. It is a simple function. And regarding this write function, this is the same function as the print. So it does the same purpose, that is, it will write the data to the LCD. So you can either use this print function or you can use this write function. and the next function is cursor. So every character will be printed using the cursor of the LCD, and if you want the cursor to be printed on the LCD, then you can call this function. So here I'm just calling the cursor function. So after printing the hello world string, I'm just calling sm.cursor. Now I'm uploading the sketch, and you can see the hello world string is printed, and after the string the cursor is printed. And the no cursor function is nothing but the inverse of cursor function. If you have enabled the cursor function using the cursor function call, you can disable that function, or you can deprint the cursor using this no cursor function call. So after this, I'm just giving a delay of 3 seconds, and I'm calling no cursor. So the hello world will be printed, and following that the cursor will be printed next to that, and it will wait for 3 seconds, and after 3 seconds the cursor will be erased. This will happen. Now I'm uploading the sketch. You can see the cursor is printed next to the hello, and after 3 seconds it is cleared. And the next function is blink. So this blink is also based on the cursor. That is, if you want the cursor to be blinking next to the string or next to the character that you are printing, you can do that by calling this function. That is, after printing the cursor, if you want the cursor to be blinking, then you can call the blink function so that the cursor will be blinking next to the string that you are printing. So now I'm uploading the sketch, and you can see the cursor is now blinking next to the text hello world. And similar to the blink, no blink is the inverse of the blink, and if you don't want the cursor to blink, you can give this function. So again I'm giving a delay of 3000, and I'm calling no blink. Now what happens is that the hello world will be printed, and the cursor is activated next to the hello world string, and then the cursor will start blinking, and for 3 seconds and it will be blinking, and after 3 seconds I have given the no blink function call, so the cursor will be stop blinking. Now I am uploading the sketch. You can see initially the hello world is printed and the cursor is blinking, and after 3 seconds the cursor stops blinking. And next function is nothing but display, which is used for turning on the display once you have turned off the display using this no display function. So this is used for turning off the display, and this is used for turning on the display. So we will demonstrate these two at a time. Now what I will do is, I will erase all this, and coming inside the void loop, I will call sm.display, and I'm giving a delay of 1 second, and then I'm calling the no display, and I'm giving a delay of 1 second. Now you can see the hello world string will be printed on the LCD, and the program control comes inside the void loop, which is the infinite loop, and here the display will be turned on and it will wait for 1 second, and after 1 second the display will be turned off and nothing will be printed on the LCD, and then it will wait for 1 second, and after executing this process continues. So the display will be turned on for 1 second and it will be turned off for 1 second. This is the programming logic. Now I'm building the sketch and uploading the sketch to the Arduino Uno. Now you can see the hello world string is now turned on for 1 second and it is turned off for 1 second. And actually what happens is, the display is turned on for 1 second and it is turned off for 1 second. And the next function is nothing but scroll display left and scroll display right. These two function calls are used for scrolling the content of the LCD or the content that is available in the LCD in a particular direction. As the name implies, this scroll display left function is used for scrolling the display from right to left direction. And this is used for scrolling the text from left to right direction. So what we will do is, I am just calling the function sm.scrollDisplayLeft, and I'm giving a delay of 100 milliseconds. Now you can see the Hello World string is now scrolling from right to left direction with a time interval of 100 milliseconds for each scroll. Now I'm changing the scroll direction from left to right. That is, I'm changing the function call to scroll display right. Now I'm uploading the sketch. You can see the display now is scrolling from left to right direction. And the next two function calls are nothing but left to right and right to left. So these two function calls are used for changing the text printing direction. That is, usually when you print a content or a string hello, the H will be printed in a particular position and the next character, that is E, will be printed on the right to the H, right? And then the character L will be printed on the right to the E. So this is the usual format, that is nothing but the left to right format. So I'm using this function call now. So I'm deleting this. So before going and printing something, I'm just going to make this function call sm.left-to-right, and then I'm going to the 8th column and 0th row of the LCD and I'm printing the text hello. Now I'm uploading the sketch. Now you can see the hello is printed on to the LCD on the 8th column and 1st row. Now when I change the direction of printing from left to right to right to left, you can see, now I'm uploading the sketch. You can see the H is printed on the 8th column and 1st row of the display and the next character E is printed on the left hand side of H, and then L is printed on the left hand side of E, and then again L is printed on left hand side of L, and O is printed on left hand side of L. So the text printing direction now is changing from left to right to right to left. And that's all about the LCD functions. That's all about the required functions that you need to understand for using LCD in your Arduino Uno. Thanks for watching. See you in the next lecture.